Welcome back to part six, finishing up your digital mandala. So let's go back to the one that I was working on. Here is what it looks like after I pasted all of my slices around in a circle. Now, as we're finishing up, we're going to look for a couple of things. So we're going to change our background color, resize, add a digital signature, and then save our design. But before we call it quits, we need to look at our digital craftsmanship. So just like any other project, digital craftsmanship is important. So I'm just looking at the neatness of it, the overall kind of spacing, the craftsmanship. So as I'm looking, just an initial kind of quick glance, looking at the spacing, my slice, these kind of blue sponges are on the edge of each side of that slice. And I notice in some areas over here they're touching, and then up here they are not touching. So I have some kind of inconsistent spacing. So it would be helpful if I were to go back and kind of readjust and kind of nudge some things over and try and make this as even as possible. I also have this kind of big empty space in the center because my triangle for my pizza slices weren't quite tall enough. Like they all kind of needed like an extra thing added onto them. I could go back and add that extra thing, or I could just find something maybe to put in the center of this design. You can go look at some other kind of student examples and see how they problem solve through that. If mine is kind of neat and complete, I can go ahead and do my last finishing up step. So I'm going to change my background color. So the best way to do this is to click on just the background itself. So it'll highlight this kind of blue square around my background. And then once I click that, you'll notice that this little swatch will pop up here and it says background color. And it'll give me some default colors, and it'll also pull colors from my photos. This will help unify with the images that I inserted. So if I go back to where I started, photo colors, it brings me with kind of just some initial suggestions from those photos. And if I click on see all, then it'll pull up all of the photos that I have inserted. What you're looking for is something that you like, but also has kind of enough contrast, but also unifies with your design. This green is a little bit maybe too bright for my taste. This light blue is kind of nice, like it has a lot of contrast, but it's not kind of too in your face. I think my original design had something kind of neutral and gray like this. So make a good color choice for your background color. The next step is to resize your entire mandala. So again, we're going to click and drag and select all of this and then drag it bigger or smaller, whatever it needs to do. And then you're going to also recenter it. So as you kind of drag it around on your page, you'll notice that you get these kind of pink crosshairs. When it is perfectly centered, you'll get a vertical and a horizontal line that tells you that your design is centered. So I'm good to go with that. And then my last step is to add a digital signature. So over here on the tab, I have a text option. Now you've got all these fun different kind of headers for text. We don't want that. We just want a simple signature. Our signature is not the star of the show. So I'm just going to click add a heading. I'm going to type my name in there. And then, just like any other artwork, I'm going to put it in kind of that bottom corner. Now, this sticks out and it is very distracting. And to be honest, the font is kind of basic and ugly. So, I'm going to change that and show you how to change it. So, if you click on your text and then you click kind of this text bar up here, it will give you all of the text. Fonts for Canva. The ones with the crowns are the premium version. We do not have Canva Pro. So pick something that's free. Pick something that kind of speaks to you and your personality. If you want something that is more of kind of like cursive, you can search for a script and that'll pull up some things that kind of maybe look more like a signature. Again, we want something that speaks to us in our personality, but is not overall too distracting. That's a little bit too fancy feeling for me. Let's go with that. The next thing I would suggest is to also change the color of your signature. So I want it to be kind of unified with what I have. That is nice and light. It kind of blends into my background. Again, your signature should not be the star of the show. So pick something that is visible, but not too distracting. That is hard to read. All right, and then your last step will be to save your design. So to do that, I'm going to click this share button. And then there should be a download option. Now, I've been working on multiple versions of this. You might only have one page and yours might look different. But I want just this one page that I've been working on. So that would be, I think that's this guy, page two. So make sure you have your correct page saved or selected. And then you're going to click download and it'll download onto your Chromebook. And then from there, you can go ahead and upload it to Canvas.